President Yoweri Museveni has said he is tired of the misleaders of our people and warned that if they don't check themselves, he will do so himself. Museveni made the firm remarks while officiating at the Thanksgiving ceremony of Energy Minister Ruth Nankawira, who was appointed a lay canon in the Church of Uganda in June this year. The canon title is the highest honor conferred upon a lay Christian in Uganda's Anglican Church for their previous commitment to serving the faith. The Thanksgiving ceremony took place at Nankabura's country home in Deje, Luero District.
When nafuna amawulire ago kulondebwa nga canon designate agenda okutwalibwa mu lukiiko lwaba bishops basalewo. Ngachi bishop akugambye bwati ogambo otya webaza bwebaza kubanga musajja wa Katonda okwo kuba kuyitibwa okuveri Katonda.
Your reappointment of Dr. Ruth Nankabira confirmed that message. And now, Ruth, you've set a very good example for us to show that the moment you are loyal to the NRM, it will never forget you.
In his comments, Museveni said many leaders have failed to help the people fight poverty due to their failure to follow and spread the NRM's wealth creation message.
So I want to thank Honorable Nankabirwa. Then, of course, that is on the development side. But also on the political side.
Next side,
we have been having our battles here. Some people wanted to bring back the politics of the 1960s, which had caused the collapse in the first place.
At the same function, the president castigated leaders who frustrate government programs aimed at developing the country. He cited his idea of building the Bujagali Dam that was blocked by parliament years ago. He further justified his move to rationalize what he referred to as parasitic government authorities and agencies.
Nankabirwa has been part of that army that has been fighting for unity of Uganda.
Aluka Lomele is the local council chairperson for Kamoru village in Nipuyon sub-county, located in Kotido district, Karamoja sub-region. The 50-year-old did not get a chance to go to school. He cannot read or even write his name in the local Karimojong language. Regardless, he has become an ardent advocate for education for all. He becomes unsettled when he sees children loitering around the village during school time. He also has no kind words for parents who refuse their children to go to school. To him, Karamoja will develop only if parents participate in educating their children. About 5 years ago, lessons were held in the open. The strong winds would disrupt the classes. Lomele mobilized parents and they built a grass-thatched hut, but it was blown away. He remobilized them and they built two makeshift classrooms with sticks and logs. This helped to shield the children and teachers from the scorching sun. Lomele has the school at heart, according to Gladys Acheng Achila, the teacher. He visits the school every day to see if all the children have attended and on time. He also goes back before lunchtime to check if the teachers are present and teaching. He is keen on how they use the instructional materials such as the newspapers they receive weekly under the Newspapers in Education NIE program, courtesy of New Vision and Save the Children. Former President Donald Trump has repeatedly promised to launch what he calls the largest deportation program in American history. If re-elected, targeting immigrants living in the United States without documentation, people whom he described in a rally this week as vicious and bloodthirsty criminals. Trump pledged to keep American communities for American citizens at a rally in Greensboro, North Carolina on Saturday, the final weekend of the tensest U.S. election of modern times.
I will keep American communities for American citizens. We're going to have American people in our communities now. We're not going to let this. Do you know that These gangs have weapons that are above military grade, and that even the police, I mean, it's like very tough, very tough. But I did a little bit.
Speaking to an energized crowd in North Carolina, U.S. Vice President and Democratic presidential candidate Kamala Harris pledges to bring down the cost of living and bridge divisions if elected president.
And I pledge to you that if you give me the chance to fight on your behalf as president, there is nothing in the world that will stand in my way. And here is my pledge to you. As president, I pledge to seek common ground and common sense solutions to the challenges you face.
On the final weekend of the tensest U.S. election of modern times, with the Democrats urging voters to turn the page on the Republicans' scorched earth brand of politics, 75 million people have already cast early ballots as the hours tick down to the election day climax Tuesday. Both held rallies in North Carolina, while Harris spoke to supporters in Georgia, another of the seven swing states seen as the keys to victory in an otherwise dead-even nationwide contest.